So dear friends, very good morning. Today we will learn about trigonometric ratios again. And for that, we will take exercise 8.1. Question number 9. The question is very good. In a triangle ABC, right angle at B. Just like, suppose it is a triangle ABC, right angle at B. This right angle at B means this is B. This is B, right angle. Right angle at B, if tan A is equal to this, find the value of sin A plus cos A. So we can take A here also, A here also, you can take anyone, but you know, take in the questions sin A cos A plus cos A sin C and cos A cos C sin A sin C means you are not talking about B because it is 90 degree, I told you. So for this A, this is A, so obviously this will be C. So A, B and C. I'm not directly talking about this. First let me clear, if you are talking about A, for this A, this will be B's. For this you can see in the second video of trigonometric ratio, B's means, you know, this angle is made between base. Suppose we take this triangle, this. So if we are talking about this angle, this, so this is this angle, this. So this is angle A. So this 90 degree, so hypotenuse is fixed. Means this is hypotenuse H, and for this A, this angle A is made up of this line and this and this and hypotenuse, so this will be base. So for this will be base, base for A, and this will be base, and the rest one, it is fixed hypotenuse, and this is the opposite side, na? Or you may say this is adjacent. In your book it is written adjacent. Adjacent means joined. This is the opposite. For A, opposite for A, base for A. So it is given tan A is equal to 1 upon root 3. If tan A is equal to 1 upon root 3, so tan is a given. So for this you'd have to know the definitions. What was Pakistan bhookha pyasa, Hindustan bhara bhara, this, and this was sine, cos and tan. So tan means perpendicular by base. So for this A, this is perpendicular or opposite. Perpendicular means 90 degree. For this you can see in my second video. This is opposite, this is perpendicular, and this is the for A. The story for the C will be changed. Okay, so A means you have to find first the value of the ratio of C, BC. So A means this is perpendicular and this is B. B means if this is root 3 and perpendicular means this is 1. Means this is 1 and this is root 3. So at that time what will be the hypotenuse? So you can take K and K, K also, K also. But in the first video I have told you K will be cancelled. So okay, so we take multiply K and K. So you can take perpendicular is equal to K and base is equal to root 3 into K. You can take, otherwise 1 is enough, 1 into K, root 3 into K. So at that time what will be the hypotenuse? So apply the Pythagoras. So Pythagoras means h square is equal to base square plus p square. Base square root 3 square plus perpendicular 1 square h square. So 3 plus 1 4, h is equal to 2. Okay. So you have found h now. So with the help of this h, you can find sine and cos. So sine a is equal to perpendicular by hypotenuse. For this a for perpendicular, this means 1, hypotenuse is 2. So sine a is equal to, okay, you can take k square, then k square. Certainly it will be 2k. So sine a is equal to perpendicular by hypotenuse means 1 upon 2, and cos, and after that cos a is equal to 1k. Actually it will be 1k upon 2k, just write, okay, 1 upon 2, and cos a is equal to base by hypotenuse root 3 by 2 k, obviously. So this one, similarly you have found sin a cos a, similarly you will find for the c. And for the c, because in the exam you will not write this base adjacent, only you will imagine. So for this, that's why I have told you for this a is equal to base, this one. But for the c, you know, c is made up with two sides. What is that? This c, this was hypotenuse and this was perpendicular for a, but for c it is the base. This was the perpendicular for the a, but for the c this is the base and this will be the perpendicular for the C. So for angle C, you know, this perpendicular only for, I have told you, for this, for the angle C, this will be as it is. This is 1, this is under root 3, and this is 2. So for the C, this is base and this is, now let me raise A, only C. This is base and this is perpendicular 90 degree, and this is hypotenuse. This, so that was the story of sine tan a, sine a and cos a. Now come on the tan c, sine c, cos c. So sine c, what is sine c? Sine c, sine perpendicular by hypotenuse, c perpendicular, this is by hypotenuse root 3 upon 2. So sine a is equal to root 3 upon 2 perpendicular by hypotenuse for the c. Cos c is equal to base by hypotenuse 1 upon 2. Oh, this is c. Sine c is equal to, and cos c is equal to 1 upon 2. So you have got this value, sin a cos a, sin c sin cos c. And now you will solve the two questions are further. Sin a cos c plus cos a sin c. You have to find the value of sin a cos c plus
cos A sin C. This is. So now place the value sin A cos C plus cos A sin C. Sin A is equal to 1 upon 2 cos C into 1 upon 2. This is multiplication. Cos A root 3 by 2. Sin C root 3 by 2. 1 upon 4, 3 upon 4, this is 4 upon 4 means 1.
Actually, this appears to be a tough question. Okay, let me solve the other part also. Second,
cos A cos C minus sin A and sin C. cos A cos C root 3 by 2 multiply cos C 1 upon 2 minus sin A 1 upon 2 into sin C root 3 by 2.
This. So this is root 3 by 4 minus root 3 by 4. So this will be 0. So write it, first part and second part. When you will come in class 11th, you know, in class 11th, in 10th it is not given. In class 11th, this question will be very easy. Actually, this is the formula. If it is written here, you can write sin of A plus C. This is the formula of sin of A plus C. This is sin A cos C plus cos A sin C. And here, sin A plus C is 90 degree because the triangle like this now. Triangle was like this. This was A, this was C, and angle B was 90 degree. So A plus C is equal to 90 degree. And this will be the formula in class 11th. A plus C 90 and sin 90 value 1. This will be. If you know this formula in the class 11th, you will be taught this formula. Cos A cos C minus sin A sin C. Here you will get formula. Cos of A plus C, this one, and this is cos 90, and cos 90 is equal to 0. You don't know, you know this value, you don't know this formula. This will be taught in class 11th. This is for the class 11th, this is for the class 10th. Same question can be solved with the help of formula, very easy. Okay, so this was for this question.
Dilli maular gulal gulabir.